We start with shocking news out of Pakistan tonight. The country's Supreme Court has ruled that the four men convicted in the murder of American journalist Daniel Pearl can go free. You may recall that Pearl was a reporter for the Wall Street Journal, investigating Islamist militants in Pakistan following the September 11 attacks. In 2002, the 38-year-old was kidnapped in Karachi and then beheaded. Video of the brutal killing was delivered to the U.S. consulate and then appeared online, designed as propaganda to sow terror and inspire other such militant murders. Indeed, Al-Qaeda in Iraq and later ISIS followed suit with gruesome film beheadings of journalists like James Foley and many more. We should note the jailed men have not yet been released in Pakistan. The process can take several days. Pearl's family says they are in complete shock and they are asking both the Pakistani courts and the U.S. government to take action to correct this injustice. With me now is Daniel Pearl's father, Judea. And welcome to the program. Welcome back from Los Angeles. You know, this must be just an awful day for you and for Ruth and your family. Just tell me your reaction when you heard this terrible news out of Pakistan.
We were in shock and total disbelief. We didn't expect this kind of outcome. All indications were that the sentiments of the Supreme Court, as well as the public, is for justice and for keeping the murderers in jail. But somehow there was an unexpected turn of event that shocked us. We can't believe how a country can afford such a move. You know, when... Go ahead.
I was going to ask you... Yeah, you go ahead, Judea.
When a killer is behind bars, and the responsibility and guilt are focused on the face of that killer. But when he's let free, then society as a whole take responsibility for the crime. And what the Supreme Court of Pakistan has done ends up with handing an indictment for the entire nation for the one of the most horrific crime in the 21st century, a crime against humanity, against journalism, against the core of our civilization. So we are very shocked and we hope that some steps will be taken to correct for this injustice. Especially we are hoping... Yeah, go ahead.
Judea, I just want to ask you what you plan to do to try to correct this injustice, as you say, because I know that you're appealing to the U.S. government to intercede. What do you think the Biden administration can do? What are you asking your country to do?
We're asking that the State Department, as well as the Department of Justice, will pursue vigorously a request for extraditing Omar Sheikh for this crime as well as for other crime that he has committed against U.S. citizens. And we hope that the Pakistani court and government will respond positively to such request and deliver Omar Sheikh for to stand trial in the U.S.
Mm-hmm. So I just want to explain for viewers who might not know, we're seeing a picture of Omar Sheikh. Now, he is a British national, and he was accused and convicted in Pakistan, along with others, of murdering Danny. Afterwards, in this, what is an acquittal now from the Supreme Court, apparently, in legal terms in Pakistan, they said that his role was less central than had been believed, that he was fundamental to the abduction of your son, but not to the murder of your son, and that he has spent something like 18 years in jail already. What is your answer to that, to the Pakistani Supreme Court?
Well, first is a question of legality. According to Pakistani law, abduction that leads to murder is punishable by death, essentially. So that's a question of legality. And then it's a question of morality. Apparently, the assessment of the Supreme Court was that his responsibility was not as estimated earlier, which is, in a sense, sending a message of impunity for would-be terrorists or would-be abductors. And there are many such potential abductors around the world, as you and I know. It's a message of impunity, yeah, which I don't believe a society can stomach at this point.
And as I said, introducing you and introducing this terrible story, Danny's brutal murder and the publicity and the publication of it was designed to sow terror and did actually launch and inspire a whole load of other similar murders of journalists and non-governmental people, NGO, aid workers and the like. What you said that you believe that the Pakistani Supreme Court would come to a different decision. What did you hope? And apparently it was a 2-1 decision. What indications had you got? Why do you think they have freed them? They are going to free them.
I can't speculate on that. I just believe it's a matter of public pressure. Pressure by a certain extreme element in the Pakistani society to ascertain their independence of the West, to ascertain their sovereignty, to express their grievances, whatever grievances they have currently against the West, and they have apparently succeeded in applying this pressure on a Supreme Court. But this is just a speculation.
And as we know, that the Pakistani government does not agree with this. It also tried to, you know, make this not happen. It was involved with you in trying to make sure that these people didn't walk free. But Judea, I want to ask you a question.
Very mildly so.
Okay.
I don't think the case as presented by the prosecutor was fought with the intensity that it deserves.
So you're asking for the Pakistani government to step up its action as well in this case?
Of course. Mm-hmm. But at this point, I don't know what they can do legally, with the exception of responding positively to U.S. requests for extradition.
Can I ask you about the role of Khalid Sheikh Mohammed? He is the accused mastermind of 9/11, and he allegedly said that it was decided and discovered, rather, that he was the one who actually physically murdered your son. Azra Nomani and others, colleagues of Danny's and friends, have done incredible investigation with law enforcement and others, and it seems that he was the one. Do you... Is that what you accept? Do you accept that Khalid Sheikh Mohammed is the actual murderer? And if so, what role do you give to Omar Sheikh and the others who are now being released?
According to the FBI report that we received, they cannot rule out the possibility that it was his hand in the picture. So, of course, he is the actual executor of the scheme and design that was planned by Omar Sheikh, and that makes Omar Sheikh not only complicit but the main instigator of the entire abduction, and that led to a murder.
I just want to give you a chance to also remind us of who Danny was and what he did, and he's got a son who now is heading to university, a son that he never met. who was born after his brutal murder. Danny was our colleague and a friend to many of us, and it's been a terrible, terrible time since he died for all of us in our profession to see how many of our professionals have been murdered brutally like he was. And I just want you to, you know, just maybe a few words about your son.
Well, his friend tells me that he had only one religion, the religion of truth. But I think he had several. Friendship, dialogue was part of his everyday practice. I'll tell you only one anecdote. When friends asked him, do you believe in the afterlife, Danny? He said, I don't know. I have many questions, more questions than answers, but I sure wish Gabriel likes my music. That was Danny.
Oh, the angel Gabriel. That's nice. Angel. That's a beautiful story. That's a beautiful story, and we all remember him always. Judea Pearl, thank you so much. And everybody's thinking about you and your wife and your family at this time.